one's mind and heart is open to take all that in, and then let it be fluid in producing something that you believe in. I think sky is really the limit, or as my partner keeps saying, mind is the limit, you know, it's not really even sky, because then we just can always recreate ourselves. We can always recreate ourselves. And I think everything we learn elsewhere can be applied to entrepreneur. I'm not saying this to undermine all the nice textbooks, the 4 P's and the 6 P's, blah, 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 you know, all that fine. But I am the unusual one where textbooks mean less to me right now, because it's just, come on, it's different times, and it was different times before Corona. So the boardroom talk is okay, fine, but it's not, I mean, the school of life is for me personally right now, is what brings value to my life. And I do encourage each and everyone out there to at least experience this and be the coach of their own life journey. You know, it's good to see coaching elsewhere, but be the coach of your own journey, you know, and just experience something extraordinary. And I said, I want to climb a mountain, and people thought I was crazy or I lost it, etc., etc. So, my beginning as a mountaineer was really like every beginning. You're testing the water, you want to explore, you're still an amateur, somehow naive. There wasn't an adventurous community in our region where I would seek for advice or for help, because it was non-existent. So it was really like a real newbie with all its mistakes. And my first mountain was Kilimanjaro. But then I was addicted and I was hooked, but I was also serious about it. So I had realistic expectations. And what I mean by that, Tamara, is that I do meet and read about lots of people that want to achieve something big, but they really have to learn first how to take baby steps. You cannot jump into something big, because you need hard work, you know? So without hard work, you don't really achieve something really big in life. On Everest, at the South Summit, reaching the South Summit, I do remember hitting the wall, and I do have vivid, I mean, I would get still goosebumps thinking about it, where I just hung on the rope, you know? And I was just like 45 minutes away from reaching the final Hillary step, and then, you know, the summit. So I did hit the wall. I was just hanging on the rope, feeling nothing, wanting to do nothing, you know, not wanting to go up or down. And I just surrendered. I just felt, you know, I want to die. No problem. If I die here, let be it. I just did not have any more in me to fight or to take one more step. Mm-hmm. And then this is when we talk about digging deep. There is always something deep inside that we can count on, you know? And I just, in that state of surrendering, I dug deep, 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 deep. And then a ball of fire just started rolling up, you know, my body. And then I wanted to be alive, number one. And I wanted just to reach or get out of the safety of that rope, and then assess the situation, whether I'm going to continue or turn around. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden I have the adrenaline, you know, in me after, you know, just sitting on that rope for a few minutes and accepting death as it comes, you know, that's it. So being scared of the success is okay sometimes, but we have to know that to reach there, you have to go through the pain. You have to go through the journey of pain. Again, what I call the hard work. And you have to be ready for it. And you have to be smart to know, okay, how far can I go? Because you don't want to go too far when it's too late or way too dangerous, you know, just to know when it's time to pause, stop, reassess, and then think it over and continue.